Blackstone Audiobooks presents The Sleeping Beauty and Other Fairy Tales, retold by A.T. Quiller-Couch. The Sleeping Beauty. Once upon a time, there lived a king and a queen who lacked but one thing on earth to make them entirely happy. The king was young, handsome, and wealthy. The queen had a nature as good and gentle as her face was beautiful. And they adored one another, having married for love, which among kings and queens is not always the rule. Moreover, they reigned over a kingdom at peace, and their people were devoted to them. What more, then, could they possibly want? Well, they wanted one thing very badly, and the lack of it grieved them more than words can tell. They had no child. Vows, pilgrimages, all ways were tried. Yet for a long while, nothing came of it all, and the poor queen especially was in despair. At last, however, to her own and her husband's inexpressible joy, she gave birth to a daughter. As soon as the palace guns announced this event, the whole nation went wild with delight. Flags waved everywhere, bells were set pealing until the steeples rocked. Crowds tossed up their hats and cheered, while the soldiers presented arms, and even strangers meeting in the street fell upon each other's neck, exclaiming, "Our queen has a daughter! Yes, yes, our queen has a daughter! Long live the little princess!" A name had now to be found for the royal babe, and the king and queen, after talking over some scores of names, at length decided to call her Aurora, which means the dawn. The dawn itself, they thought, was never more beautiful than this darling of theirs. The next business, of course, was to hold a christening. They agreed that it must be a magnificent one, and as a first step, they invited all the fairies they could find in the land to be godmothers to the Princess Aurora. That each one of them might bring her a gift, as was the custom with fairies in those days, and so she might have all the perfections imaginable. After making long inquiries, for I should tell you that all this happened not so many hundred years ago, when fairies were already growing somewhat scarce, they found 7. But this again pleased them, because 7 is a lucky number. After the ceremonies of the christening, while the trumpeters sounded their fanfares and the guns boomed out again from the great tower, all the company returned to the royal palace to find a great feast arrayed. Seats of honour had been set for the 7 fairy godmothers, and before each was laid a dish of honour, with a dish cover of solid gold, and beside the dish a spoon, a knife, and a fork, all of pure gold, and all set with diamonds and rubies. But just as they were seating themselves at the table, to the dismay of everyone, there appeared in the doorway an old crone, dressed in black and leaning on a crutched stick. Her chin and her hooked nose almost met together, like a pair of nutcrackers, for she had very few teeth remaining. But between them, she growled to the guests in a terrible voice,
"I am the fairy, Uglyane. Pray, where are your king's manners that I have not been invited?"
She had, in fact, been overlooked, and this was not surprising, because she lived at the far end of the country, in a lonely tower set around by the forest. For 50 years she had never come out of this tower, and everyone believed her to be dead or enchanted. That, you must know, is the commonest way the fairies have of ending. They lock themselves up in a tower or within a hollow oak, and are never seen again. The king, though she chose to accuse his manners, was in fact the politest of men. He hurried to express his regrets, led her to table with his own hand, and ordered a dish to be set for her. But with the best will in the world, he could not give her a dish cover such as the others had, because 7 only had been made for the 7 invited fairies. The old crone received his excuses very ungraciously while accepting a seat. It was plain that she had taken deep offence. One of the younger fairies, Hippolyta by name, who sat by, overheard her mumbling threats between her teeth, and fearing she might bestow some unlucky gift upon the little princess.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.